After its debut as weightlifting in the Tokyo 1964 Paralympic Games, the sport, now known as powerlifting, expanded from just male lifters with a spinal cord injury to include athletes with physical impairments that affect their lower limbs or hips, or athletes with short stature. Female powerlifters made their Paralympic debut in 2000. Powerlifting is the ultimate test of upper body strength, and you'll often see athletes lifting more than three times their own body weight. Powerlifters are split into 10 different categories based on body weight for each gender. Powerlifting consists of one discipline, a bench press. Unlike the able-bodied sport where athletes use their feet on the floor to assist the bench press, Paralympic athletes lie totally flat on a completely different style of bench. Each competitor has 2 minutes to complete their attempt. When the lifter has the bar under full control, they must wait until they receive the command, start.
Stop!
Then they have to lower the bar in a controlled manner and definitively stop it on the chest. Next, they press it upwards, lock out both elbows simultaneously and hold the bar under control until the referees command to wrap. At least two white lights are required from three referees for a good lift. A red light indicates a bad lift. Athletes have three attempts, and the winner is the athlete that lifts the heaviest weight. In the third round, two weight changes are permitted. The weight change can be higher or lower. No changes are allowed if the lifter has already been called to the platform by the speaker, and or if the bar has already been loaded. To attempt a new record, it must exceed the previous one set by a minimum of 0.5 kilograms. Where a world record is broken during the actual three lifts of competition, the 0.5 kilograms does not count towards the competition total, but is rounded down to the full kilogram. The jury may allow a fourth attempt for a world record. This adds suspense to the competition, as a lifter could break the world record but may not win gold. Powerlifting offers a tense and dramatic spectacle where coaches have to be good strategists as their athletes battle to outlift their rivals.
Well, hello again. It's the afternoon session on day two of the Dubai 2021 Powerlifting World Cup from the Sport Club for the Determines in Eastern Dubai. So it's the men's 54 kg we have now. There are nine in this. And again, quite a lot of the top lifters in the world in this discipline are jousting for success. So the 59 kg, that was a fabulous event earlier, won by Kiyun Kai of China, ahead of Thomas Kure of Nigeria. And we're now on to the men's 54 kg. The 56 kg is on after this, with athletes from Cote d'Ivoire, Cuba, Egypt, Greece, Japan, Kyrgyzstan, Peru, Russia, and Ukraine. The reigning world champion is in this. Sheriff Osman is our world record holder, 205. Mascalis Kulamoglu, the junior world record holder, 148. We saw him earlier in the heavier 59 kg category. So these are the nine involved. The world champion, Vladimir Krivolya, we'll see lifting last. Paralympic bronze medalist and the African silver medalist, Abdelmajid Taha. Former Pan Am champion, twice over, Cesar Rubio as well. Our referees, Ahmed Al-Mohammadi, Haider Araba, and Colorado Bernacci. And here's our jury for today.
Ladies and gentlemen, the technical officials for the session are the chief referee from Brazil, Conrado Brunacci, left side referee from Palestine.
A hive of activity. Backstage in the warm-up area. So here we go, the men's 54 kg, the second lightest of the men's weight categories. So we've America's and European champions and the reigning world champion in this as well.
For the first attempt, representing Côte d'Ivoire, Vance Osseni.
Roland Ezuruke of Nigeria, the reigning Paralympic champion in this. So, from Côte d'Ivoire, Vance Osseni, no major championships up to this point. And he's starting off at 45 kg. Just a quick word that at the moment, eighth spot in the men's 54 kg in terms of the Paralympic ranking. Choi Kyun-jin, 153 kg. We'll see what changes happen there today. So we haven't seen him at a major championship before. He is 46 years old. Might be going to flags here, I think. Yeah, there was a straightness issue, basically. So that's a strikeout this time. That's actually, it's been really interesting talking at different major events. It was good at the end, just on the way. Yeah, you see there. But it's interesting talking to athletes from different countries and coaches as well, when you come to major events, particularly countries that have not had much of a history going back too many years in powerlifting. Likes of Gambia have only been involved in the last major championship or two, and their coach is also one of their country's main football commentators. Don't think they're here. They only have one lifter, and the thing is, there can be no domestic competition if you've only got one lifter in the country. So the sport's still growing in some parts of the world. And here for the Kyrgyz Republic, Azizbek Zamirbek Ulu. Again, hasn't been in a major championship before. Bansuseni 46. Azizbek is 18 years old, lives in Bishkek. He's a student. He is interested in this sport because he saw it on TV. And he said, I'd like to try that. And ultimately, isn't that what it's all about? Coach is Adnan Jabrailov. We've seen him actually not very far away from Kyrgyzstan on a global scale in Kazakhstan and Nur-Sultan at the World Championships. He was in the juniors there and he finished fourth. Bronze already this year in the Tbilisi World Cup events in Georgia. Whiteout. That's lovely. Clearing 110 all through, not a worry. And that was superb. Still a junior. World Championships on later this year in one of the great powerlifting venues of EGA. Former Pan Am champion, Cesar Rubio of Cuba. Those World Championships starting the 1st of December. It'll be in your diaries. Cesar Rubio, who took gold in Rio in 2007, Guadalajara in 2011 at the Pan Ams. He's never actually competed at a World Championships, but he has been at three Paralympic Games. His best result, 8th in 2004. Based in Villa or Villa Clara, his club there as well. And he's gunning for 115 here. .147 is his all-time best. It's not on the Tokyo pathway. So 115, a man who's been a master in the Americas, doing well in Dubai. Thank you very much. So whiteout, and that's all good. Diego Quispe of Peru. Only 22 years old, definitely up and coming. Sixth in Lima. Home sweet home for the Pan Ams. In 2019, Lima is his home city. And he started this sport 4 years ago to strengthen his body. Just turned out there was a major international sporting event on in his city, in which he could compete 2 years later. And no mark when he made his major championship debut in the European Open Championships in Berks-sur-Mer 2018. Coach Nylander Suarez. So 1:15 to start. It's a whiteout for him. And he's into the lead. Originally was going for 120, 115 he went for in the end. Actually, in terms of body weight, Rubio Guerra still has it on him, and he's only about 390 grams lighter. So Rubio in front, Kispe in second place. They've both lifted 115. The weights take a bit of a leap now, up to 140 for Mitsunari Ichikawa of Japan. We've only seen him on the international scene the past couple of years. Made his major championship debut in Japan, in Kitakyushu, when he was sixth in the Asia Oceania Championships. He's taken silvers at the Japan Championships, and he was in Kitakyushu. Getting his bedding into the sport. The World Championships the following year in Nur-Sultan. 10th, made his major debut at the age of 44. Silver in the World Cup event in Eger 2 years back in Hungary. And you know, ordinarily that's the big event of the year, but it's not been a normal year. Takeyoshi Okamoto, his coach at national level, lives in Hadano. ...140 for the lead. 138 is best in terms of the Paralympic ranking. That has him 10th. He's 15 kilos off Choi Kun-jin. ...141 is lifetime best. Oi! He's close to his lifetime best, but there's a reason why a lifetime best is a lifetime best. It's up to this point a once-in-a-lifetime thing. But in saying that, Ki-young Kai had a similar experience in the previous event, the men's 59 kg. Added 1 kilo to the bar, lifted it, won it, took the gold. It's always a bit terrifying when that happens. It'll just be a moment when the hands kind of give way. But the spotters have a big job to do. Dimitrios Bakochristos for Greece. The 2015 European champion, silver in 2013 in Alexi, and he took the big glory. Where else? Eger. Bronze in the last two World Championships in Mexico City 2017. Nur-Sultan 2 years ago. Bronze in Rio. Gunning for 141 here. He's currently third in the Paralympic ranking. 181 is lifetime best. 166 he's lifted in qualifying in terms of the Paralympics, and pretty much successful qualifying and successful here. A whiteout! 3 out of 3, he's our new leader on 141.
The bar is loaded for his first attempt representing Ukraine, Konstantin Panasiuk.
So now for Ukraine, Konstantin Panasiuk came very close to his first major championship medal in Baksimir when he was fourth in the Europeans by the sea 3 years ago. He's aiming for 150 here. Individually, he's not won a major championship medal, but it was team bronze in the team event at the Worlds in Nur-Sultan in 2019. Medaled quite a bit on the World Cup circuit. 150 is target for the lead here. 156 is lifetime best. That is the mark that has him in seventh place in the Paralympic rankings. There you go. Another whiteout, and he is our new leader, Konstantin Panasiuk. And we salute you, sir. Two to go in this opening round. Taha Abdelmajid of Egypt. 160 his target. The Paralympic bronze medalist in London. And he's won at this Fazza World Cup in Dubai in 2016 and 2019. The Egger World Cup in 2017, among all his successes. Bronze in the World Championships in 2010, African Championship silver in 2018, and African Games bronze in 2015. Abdelmajid for Egypt at 160. 172 is his lifetime best. 166 is best in terms of the Paralympic ranking, and he's lying second in that behind David Deitarev of Kazakhstan. So we'll see him in Tokyo. All going well. It's a bit of an old struggle. He got it raised. Think we're going to the flags? We don't need to. And he doesn't need to worry about that mark again. Two out of three in his favor. And that is our new leader, Taha Abdelmajid. Took a while, but he got there. So one more to go.
The bar is loaded for his first attempt representing Russia, Vladimir Krivolia.
Vladimir Krivolia of Russia, the reigning world champion, the former European champion from his home Euros in Alexin in 2013, Paralympic bronze in London 2012. Wasn't in Rio. gunning for 177 for a big lead. This is lifetime best. He's, you know, he's not in the Tokyo pathway. But might pick up one of those 20 qualification invites. Might not. 177 to go in front. No time wasted, white out. And that is a substantial advantage. Nice and clean. And Krivulja goes into the gold medal position. And already he leads by 17 kg. It's going to take quite an effort, and I think actually quite a few lifetime bests, in order to dislodge him. Just going to be a slight end of the second round because Krivulja's mark has updated in an irregular way. He lifted 177. It's re-emerged as 182, but that presumably is what he's going for in round two. So it'll take a few seconds to get that system ironed out. Krivulja with 177 is our leader. He's 17 clear of Abdul Majid in second. And Panasiuk in third on 150. Baka Christos in fourth has lifted a weight greater than Vladimir Krivulja's 177. They've got the system working again. So, Franz Busseni of Côte d'Ivoire, second attempt at 45. I think the big battle now, frankly, is for the silver. Unless one of the rest of the field shows remarkable ambition. So, Busseni, welcome aboard. Côte d'Ivoire have had 12 international class power lifters across time. Right now, another strikeout. It's getting it raised. There's no problem about that. It's how he's going about it. It's just dipping on that right hand side, the left of your picture there. He's got the strength, definitely. And he's not that far off. It's the sort of thing that probably relatively iron outable. Azizbek Zamirbek Ulu of Kyrgyzstan. I cleared 110 in round one, going for 117 now. 115 is his lifetime best. Nice result in Tbilisi, the most recent World Cup, the fourth of the five, and we are watching the fifth of the five. This would see him leap up into fifth place. He's currently seventh. No lift. So two and against, no luck. Close though. Not necessarily a major difficulty. So on we go, Cesar Rubio of Cuba. In 20s, aiming for now. I mean, his lifetime best is way above this, 147. Four Parapana medals, silvers in the last two, Lima and Toronto, golds in Guadalajara and Rio, going back to 2007 in Rio. This will raise in one place if it's good, and it is. And it is a whiteout for Cesar Rubio. Goes to 120. Right now, bronze is 150. Fourth place is 141. He's doing enough for now. Diego Quispe of Peru, 115 in the opening round, 120 is target again. So he equaled his lifetime best with the previous lift. This for a brand new one. Aiming for 120. Hasn't lifted that in competition prior to today, but now he has. It's a whiteout, it's 3 for 3. Quispe keeps his position on the leaderboard, he'll stay in sixth place. But that's the new PB. Mitsunori Chikawa. Chikawa holding on for Japan. So Ichikawa, well, he missed out 140 in the opening round, going for 140 again now. Lifetime best 141. He is involved in Tokyo qualifying here, lying in 10th spot. He would stay in 10th spot, but go a little bit closer to 9th than Ali Al-Daraji. It's the top 8. Who get the nod for Tokyo. And they are 8 different nationalities as well. Ichikawa, Nishizaka, and Kos are all, from a Japanese point of view, have been trying to jostle for position in this 54kg, but they're outside the top 8. So 140, a kilo off his lifetime best. So raised at 140, yes, that's it. Well, he missed out entirely last time, but that was a beaut. One, and Ichikawa goes into fifth position, and that very close to his all-time best. A marvelous attempt. Nothing more to say about that. That was gorgeous. Dimitrios Bakochristos is one of those lifters who has in his career gone higher than Krivulia's current mark of 177. For Bakochristos, 141 in the opening round, this for 150, this to try and overtake Panasiuk and to go into the bronze medal position. He's lifted 156 in his career, so this would be a new lifetime best. He would stay seventh if successful on the Paralympic ranking. Bakochristos then at 150.
Good lift.
There you go. He's done it. 150 for Bakochristos. His career has gone up to 181. 150 puts him into the bronze medal position above Konstantin Panasiuk. He will have his say next.
Is loaded for his second attempt representing Ukraine,
Konstantin Panasiuk.
Panasiuk going for 159. 160 is currently the silver medal mark, but that's Abdelmajid, who's slightly, and I do mean slightly, by about 100 grams lighter in body weight at the weigh-in than Panasiuk. So Abdelmajid on the head-to-head would take it if they were finishing in the same mark. So Panasiuk going for 159 instead of 161. This just to go back into the bronze medal position, but maybe may yet have a BDI on silver. It is doable for Panasiuk. Panasiuk in seventh on the Paralympic ranking. Strikeout for Panasiuk. He stays in fourth. So Baka Christos stays in the bronze medal position. Baka Christos and Panasiuk both on 150. Baka Christos lighter in the body weight, so he's third. Panasiuk fourth. Taha Abdelmajid, 160. He's in second place. Going for 163 here. 172 is lifetime best. He is second on the Paralympic ranking with 166. Abdelmajid. Didn't see him in Rio, actually. Oh, we definitely saw a lot of him in London when he came through in third spot. Oh yes! Oh yes! Taha Abdelmajid looking in good form with the Paralympic Games in Tokyo just around the corner.
Loaders, please load the bar to 182 kilograms, rack height 12.
And there is just a special soundtrack when you've got the Middle Eastern, North African nations lifting. Brilliantly supportive, it is evocative, and it's successful here.
Next will be the last attempt for round two in this competition.
163 he got, that was actually quite brilliant, really. Final attempt of this second round, and it is our leader, Vladimir Krivulya. 177 in the opening round, this for 182 from the reigning world champion.
Vladimir Krivulya,
coach, not on stage, Nadezhda Krivolya. $189 is lifetime best. Is knocking on the door of it.
Can make it, Vladimir. 182 kilograms. $189,
that European record that he set, the World Championships in Nur Sultan, this 182. And it's good, 2-1. And Krivolya extends his lead to 19.
Still leading in this competition. We'll start the third round. Loaders, please. Load the bar to 45 kilograms.
Right. He's looking good for it. That will be the gold. Nobody's going to try and challenge that in the final round.
The first place with 182 kilograms, followed by Taha Bimbajin from Egypt.
Really impressive.
The third place is for the Greek, Dimitrios Bakokristos. The bar is loaded for his third and last attempt, representing Cote d'Ivoire, Vance Ossini.
Not much more to say about that. It was just terrific. So, Vance Ossini of Cote d'Ivoire, his third and final attempt, going for 45. So he's bombed out with the previous two attempts, so he doesn't want to. He struck out with the previous two attempts, so he doesn't want to bomb out with this. It's been kind of obvious what's been happening with the previous two lifts, so sort of thing that actually they'll have had a great chance of being able to address behind the scenes for the last 20 minutes or so. I'm afraid not. So he has struck out for a third time. He has bombed out. It is a bit of a blowout. That's the thing to be worked on.
The bar is loaded for his third and last attempt. The junior from Kyrgyzstan, Azizbek Zamirbekoglu.
Tabas Usseni, no mark for him, unfortunately. We'll see him at further World Cup events. This is Azizbek Zamirbekoglu for Kyrgyzstan. 110. In the opening round, missed out 117, this for 120. So missed that 117, but is still looking to add to his tallies, following his plan, going for 120. Bit of a struggle this one at 120, which would have been his second lifetime best of the day, but just too much on this occasion. Didn't get it, finishes on 110. Junior honors forthcoming, and at senior he is in eighth. Cesar Rubio of Cuba going for 122. Only adding a further 2 kilos to the mark, but it would send him up a place above Diego Quispe for now. Been a former footballer before. Two to one against. So Cesar Rubio stays at 120. It would have given him a little lift by one place, but it has not happened. And 120, his best result. Final attempt for Peru for Diego Quispe. I've got ahead of myself a bit. Cesar Rubio isn't the former footballer. Diego Quispe is. 120 in the second round, which has him in seventh place. This for 126, and he would finish in sixth if successful. He has equaled his lifetime best today and then broken it. Now trying to break it for a second time. So Quispe aiming for 126. Which would be a nice round out to his competition, and it would be 3 for 3 if successful. But he's not. He has struck out. So he's left on 120. And he finishes in 7th place, Rubio in 6th. 5 to go. So at the moment, 3rd and 4th are on 150. 5th, Ichikawa, 140. But he's going for 145, so he finishes in 5th no matter what he does here. Two attempts at 140. For a new lifetime best. To go past his mark of 141 from previously. So if he gets this, he would go to just outside the top 8 places in the Paralympic ranking. He'd be 9th. He would be, in terms of that, a first alternate. Well, remembering that there are 20 qualification invites outside of those who qualify automatically. If your country's quota is full, if you don't already have an athlete in a particular category. Ichikawa then, 145. Well, he got it raised. Ah, but just a bit too ragged. At least he knows he was able to get it pushed up, but not the way required, and his lifetime best remains 141. He's given a good tilt though. He cleared 140 in the second round, had missed it previously, missed 145 there, and he finishes in 5th. Nice result. Four remaining. Dimitrios Bakou-Christos waiting for his cue, which isn't now because it's Konstantin Panisiuk first. So, Bakou-Christos is in the bronze medal position, 150. Panisiuk, 150. Missed 159. Going for 159 again here. To get up into the bronze medal position, he'd have needed to go 164. In an attempt for the silver. One 5.6 is his lifetime best. No. So Panasiuk finishes on 150. And then the check to see. But it hadn't worked out.
The bar is loaded for the third and last attempt, representing Greece, Dimitrios Bakou-Christos.
Come on, Dimitrios. So this is Bakou-Christos. So at the moment he's tied with Panisiuk on 150. And again, likewise, he's going here for 160, by the way. Because Panisiuk was going for 159, and Bako Christos, if he'd gone for 159, would have been able to overtake. He's pitching a 160. Abdelmajid in the silver middle position at 163. So all of the medals are locked in now in that order. Nobody's going to overtake anyone else. 160 for Bako Christos. That's the attempt. He has lifted 181 in his career. He's lifted 166 to put him third in the Paralympic ranking at present. We will see him in Tokyo. It's been a nice training session for a Sunday morning. 141, 150, 160. He takes the bronze. A whiteout as well. Good work. Very, very, very good work by Dimitrios Bako Christos. Bako from Mona Styraki in Athens, involved in family cheese business. Or I'll put it to you like this, at least his family's involved in a family cheese business. Two to go! For Egypt, Taha Abdelmajid, 160, 163. This for 166. Kenny's kind of pitched himself a particular way. Not chasing the gold in the same way Bako Christos wasn't chasing the silver. In the same way Panisiuk wasn't chasing the silver. Abdelmajid has that now. And the time's on just on the scoreboard purely. It looks curious that we might try to add on another couple of kilos, but those in the back room, in the warm-up area, they're pretty knowledgeable, the coach and the athlete, about what they are capable of and how much is still within them. And Bako Christos and Panisiuk probably just felt Abdelmajid's tally of 163 from the second round was too much and didn't aim for it. He was brilliant in that second round, that lift of 163. Regular medalist, and he gets another one here. There's one here. 2016, 2019, and it is silver on this occasion. Can he go 3 for 3 with this 166? Got it raised. He's tentative about it, and he hasn't got it. Still gets the silver though, and this man has got the gold, Vladimir Krivolyov of Russia. Now 177 and 182. The two lifts so far that in their own right would have been enough to win the gold. This for 186. His European record in claiming gold in the last World Championships in Nur-Sultan, 189. Won't go for it in this round anyway. He's had a perfect combination to date. And Krivulja didn't get that one. Two to one against 182 is where he finishes the competition on. Job done, and he wins the Dubai World Cup. Didn't get the final lift. Got it up, but didn't look like it was pressed upwards equally. Krivulja takes the gold, 182 for Russia. Abdelmajid, the silver for Egypt, and Bako Christos, the bronze for Greece. This is where we are on the qualification pathway. It's not changed today. And I hope you took notes. There we go. Tarev of Kazakhstan with the leading tally of 185. Abdelmajid, Bako Christos, Bruno Kara, Ali Jawad. He's taking a few hours off from watching the Euros, the European football. Bourlon, Panisyuk, and Choi are the eight men in prime position for Tokyo. So we're back in half an hour. It is 3 p.m. 1500 Dubai time, and in 30 minutes it's the men's 65 kg. It's a longer one, two groups in it. We will be back very soon.